Examine things, especially when they're important to you. Don't fall prey to your own thinking biases. As we'll see, biases are very prominent in our thinking. Categorical thinking is the default for human beings, right? Schema-based processing. Once you've come up with a rule for interpreting something, we tend to apply it whether it applies or not. And oftentimes we'll skew the information we get later to actually justify the rule that we have, because we don't want to believe that we're making bad assumptions. So one of these biases is the confirmation bias. It's a tendency to seek evidence that confirms one's belief. When we get into the social psychological chapter, we're going to talk about self-fulfilling prophecies. How believing something about somebody or situation leads to you actually causing the situation to come out in a similar manner as you thought it would come out, thus confirming your original bias. But had you not had the bias, it might have turned out differently. A rather classic example of this, where when kids in a classroom were randomly assigned by a researcher to be either thought of as good students or bad students. And so they took, you know, bogus feedback and they gave it to the teachers and they told them they were either good students or bad students. And the teachers then created good students and bad students. Not intentionally, but because they thought they had a belief that was well based in reality. And then they would treat the kids different in a way that actually caused them to behave different. So if you think a kid's a bad student, you treat them a little differently. If you think they're a good student, you treat them a little differently. Not consciously, because most people say, well, I would never do that. That's not fair. That's not the kind of person I am. But the idea is that once you have an idea, it becomes a schema that then guides your behavior in ways that you're not conscious of. Implicit operation then causes you to behave in ways that actually cause other people, if you remember back to reciprocal determination, behave in ways that then confirm your bias, not only because you change their behavior as a function, but because then you're selective in seeking the information. Right, you then are likely to interpret it in a way that's consistent with your already, you know, prejudged belief. Illusory correlation. Erroneous belief that two variables are related when they're actually not, or they're related in directions you don't believe they're related in. We tend to focus on instances where there seems to be a relationship, ignoring disconfirming instances. Now, my favorite example, though you could dicker with its accuracy on depending on how we slice up and operationally define the key variable, is a stereotype, which we'll talk more about. So if you generally stereotype, now you have to admit that stereotypes exist, and then just tell me which one is a stereotype. Women are great drivers or women are bad drivers?
Women are bad drivers.
What's the stereotype? Not what you believe. What's the stereotype? Okay, it's a fairly commonly held stereotype that women are bad drivers. Now, what is a bad driver? To me, bad driving means you cause a crash, right? Now, if you look at the crash data and you look at maybe how do we operationalize crash, bad crash versus minor crash, looking at property damage, time lost from work, and other kinds of related issues, injuries and deaths. Who causes more of those, women or men?
Men.
By far and away. If you know anything about actuarial tables and how insurance companies charge people premiums, who gets charged more for driving, men or women?
Men.
So who's the dangerous driver? Who's the bad driver? Well, that's a great point here, right? People, that's belief perseverance. So in the face of evidence, people want to keep believing what they've always been believing. But to look at the illusory correlation, what you would have in practice would be something like this. Let's say I held that stereotype that women are bad drivers, right? And I get cut off in traffic. And of course, nobody ever cuts anybody else off, right? It's always, you would never do that. You would never accidentally cut somebody off in traffic. But somebody cuts me off, and I motor up real quick to see who did that to me. And if it's a female, I'm going to go, I knew it! Woman driver. That's how they are, you know. Everybody knows they can't drive. But if I motor up and I look in and it's a guy, I'm going to go, asshole. He's just one of those that can't, but he's an exception to my rule. You see what I'm saying? In other words, I'm going to hold that data as an exception to my general rule. If I was looking to validate my general rule on more realistic criteria, I would find my general rule doesn't generally hold at all. In fact, might want to switch it up a little bit. But people don't do that. People do what they've always done. Once they get beliefs, once they hold particular kinds of heuristics or cognitive processes, they want to hold on to them. I took off belief perseverance because this is focusing you in on test material. Thank you for coming today, right? But that's the idea, is we actually skew data in our real world and interpret it consistent with our already existing beliefs. That's not fair, but it is reality. And if you know this about yourself, it should give you pause to wonder about, well, I wonder about these rules that I apply to interpreting all these situations, whether they're really valid. And it should give you maybe a little bit of compassion. Hopefully, you would help people see the error of their ways with the new knowledge you've got. But at the same time, if you see people making mistakes like this, you would go, well, they're not total jerks trying to be wrong. They're normal people operating under normal circumstances that unless they've been trained to think differently, they won't. And that's a hard thing to do. It's a hard task to come up against to try to get people to objectively evaluate their own way of looking at the world and interpreting the world and judging. We're judging machines. We judge quick and we judge very harshly in some cases.